the same thing happened, Paul, where Cam Howard went to him, and then all of a sudden they went and went their separate ways, and all of a sudden Cross picks up 10 kicks, and his effectiveness when
he
gets the ball.
He's a hard-working footballer, and he does use it well, so you notice him.
Benny Giobbe on him.
So funny the way games of footy work themselves out. At Bournemouth opened up being a 4-goal 2 lead instead of a 2-goal 6 lead. This game had probably over. Noble Park probably could have just rolled over and Bournemouth could have kept going on. So a bit of bad kicking in front of goal opened the door for the Bulls in the middle of that quarter, and they're able to fight their way back into this game. So it bodes well for the rest of the afternoon. The Tigers get the first clear possession of the second quarter. That was through Fraser, who's had a pretty good start to this game out here this afternoon at Baldwin Park. At the centre-half forward, Hughes taps the ball forward to Gordon, who's looking for the free kick for too high, didn't get it. Hughes on hands and knees.
Well,
gives away a free kick for a throw. It was there.
Most definitely was there.
Going to come back the way of Morrison Ryan it is. Goes back across goal, finds Tim Kelly. Short kick there to Tobin, former Box Hill Hawk. He's going to come into the middle of the ground on the lead. Strong grab at its highest point. Timothy Harper. He's a tough nut. He's been a tough nut for a couple of years in this Noble Park team. He's looking for Wright out on the far side in front of the cricket nets. And the ball just bounces in front of him and goes out of bounds for a boundary throw in at half forward. So, well, a great kick there by Harper, but a good mark before that. We'll have a boundary throw in. It's fake up against Meeson. Ball comes to ground. Wright handballs back to Meeson, who has one arm pinned in the Joby tackle. It was an absolute cracker. There's Taylor Gilchrist. Handballs to Milhausen. The bouncing ball to the middle of the ground. It's going to work out well for the Tigers. They move the ball well through hands. Up at centre-half forward. Centre-half back for them now. Gilchrist. Handballs chopped off there, though, by Brett Dorr, who gets around one. Long left foot kick to the teeth of goal. And he had Vergen fake all by himself about 30 metres out. And that would have been a great start to the second term. It's a minor score, 2 points the margin now. Let's cross down boundary side. Thanks to Chiropractic Betting and Lana Coleman.
Yeah, I was down at the Noble Park huddle at quarter time and they were really impressed with how they were going. They realised that Baldwin probably coughed up a few chances and have let them stay in the game. But they're really happy with the forward line, how they competed, their pressure, and their real focus for this quarter was to put the pressure on Baldwin because they know that they'll turn the ball over. So that's, I suppose, the main message that we got from the quarter time huddle for Noble Park.
Certainly going to be an intriguing next three quarters. Thanks very much, Alana. As numbers all with Noble Park as they go inside forward 50 once again. Peter Wright was in front position, couldn't make the most of it, but Tim Harper could.
Post.
And unfortunately, the kick wasn't all that flash. Jeez, just nicked the post on the way through.
But those are the sort of opportunities.
That was a gimme goal, Brash. That was as good as running into an open goal.
Yeah, and you've got to take them because if you don't take them against a quality side, they're going to come back and hurt you.
And Noble Park 2-5-17 on the Bendigo Bank scoreboard, trail by 1 point, all in 2-6-18.
3 minutes into the second term. Short kickouts from fullback seem to be the way now. Roach gets the handball from Wright. Right back in the back pocket. It's a risky kick. It finds Penry though. Takes the mark in front of Luke Cody. He's got Cross down the line, who's into some space again. Eventually he kicks it to Gordon, who's got three Bulls to beat. Gives away the free kick, or is he going to get a free kick for...
No.
No, gave away the free kick.
He knew exactly what he was doing.
Well,
he just wanted to interrupt the contest. Yeah.
He was outnumbered 3-1, so... try and get away with it, which he couldn't, but on another day he might have done. The kick from Dorr is long and strong to the goal line. Penderbury not able to take the mark, and
you're joking.
Off the ground! On the hands and knees, made something out of absolutely nothing. There's your Chiropractic Betting goal of the day so far.
I thought he was going to signal a point there.
And Wright signaled, is celebrating. I think that's a goal.
So basically, for those who are listening, he's dropped it. Fallen to the ground, and then as it's bounced on the ground, he's kicked it off the ground at the goal square.
It's clearly a goal.
I think it's clearly a goal.
I can't say why it wouldn't be.
And the goal umpire, the Brains Trust have it all sorted. On the board, Wright's got his second. The Bulls have number three. The margin's out to 5 points. 3-5-23 plays 2-6-18 on the Bendigo Bank scoreboard.
I back Jim, Paul.
Thank you very much.
I've always thought that the Cotham Road end has always been the scoring end of the ground.
Cotham Road end.
Yeah.
It doesn't turn into Cotham Road until you get up to the Burke Street intersection.
I thought it did at Baldwin Road.
Let's not argue about geography.
I always thought that's been the scoring end of the ground. Yeah. And if Noble Park can pinch, two or three quick goals here, that's going to put the pressure on.
It's the downhill end, Brash. Seems to always be there.
Go with the white horse right or the tram tracks into the ground.
Tram tracks.
So kick comes in inside the ball and forward 50. Hughes ducked his head, tried to get away. Gordon will be in front position here, gives his handball away. Tregear went no hands and just tried to boot it inside forward 50. Takes a right turn as trying to pick it up there as Paul. And he's wrapped up about 30 metres out from his defensive goal.
Dan Donati will not like that piece of play from Tregear. That was lazy and very slack.
So Fake and Meeson to go in the ruck once again. There's probably no real genuine second option for a ruckman for both these sides today.
Tim Pony's been running through there for the Tigers.
Good point. Kemperman tries to get it away now, trying to get the foot to the ball was Kelly. Eventually Noble Park clear to centre wing. Trying to get around here was Milhoisen.
Great tackle.
And he's wrapped up going absolutely nowhere. Good tackle there from Jim Harper.
Yeah, he was all over him like a cheap blanket, Dan. He just couldn't get rid of the ball.
And right in the middle of SEN Park. A great game of footy for your Queen's birthday weekend. Traditionally a standalone fixture, this one, but sharing the Saturday with a few other games around the Eastern Football League this afternoon. We've seen a cracker so far. That's some sharp work there by Ryan. He gets rid of his opponent and gives it straight back. Here's Tamponi on the lead. Just over his outstretched hands. And the Bulls left the chance to get rid of that footy. Go Bulls. Bit up in the lucky fashion, ends up with the footy. And Trent Robertson ends up wrapping up Goebbels and brings him to ground.
A little bit of a genuine panic from Noble Park.
There is a bit in there.
There's a couple of players who are just getting the ball and fretting a little bit.
There's a bit of fumbling and things going on. There's Meeson. He taps the ball into some space. Tobin just picks it up and handballs it in front of Anderson. It's the numbers here with the Bulls. If Allen can get rid of Cross, which he does, Anderson goes in and picks it up, and Cross was still on Ronnie's hammer. Anderson just over the head of Dorr. It's a smart kick in the end. It should trickle out and over the boundary line and half forward. And that's a very good win for the Noble Park Footy Club.
That's the Rugby League 40-20.
It is.
Touch beautifully.
It was a 3-on-1. Cross got shepherded out by Allen and was still able to affect some pressure on Anderson as he got the kick away. So Fake and Meeson. Meeson gets the tap down. Roach. Handball's out wide. Short kick over the top of Tobin versus Fraser. And not a great kick to Fraser. But
Fraser got a jumper promotion this year. He was 37 last year, was he not?
Yes, he was.
Yeah, he was. There you go.
Moving up the ranks.
Absolutely. Just unable to settle either side here. Noble Park probably, this is in their favour. The game stays frenetic like this. Cross throws the footy out. Kemperman handballs to the feet of a teammate. They're doing well here, the Bulls. Now they're going to go inside 50. It's Kyle Martin on the left foot from 40 metres. Put down your glasses. I don't think they've kicked the last three, the Noble Park boys. They have, certainly. 4-5-29, plays 2-6-18. That's a great finish of Kyle Martin on the left boot after Alana and Soupy rip shreds off him for not using the footy well. Nothing wrong with his foot skills there, the former Magpie. He's nailed that one post-height.
Boundary.
It's crossed down boundary side. Thanks to Life
Care, you're Alana in trouble now.
Oh, I never said that. I said it took him 10 disposals to get his efficiency up, and now he's very efficient. Thank you very much.
Certainly is. And, of course, that's thanks to Corrupted Betting, not to Life Care.
Ball back in the middle once again. Giobi gets his kick away. Wasn't all that flash. Monaghan tried to get his away. Fergan Fake was held. Keane got his handball away. Managed to release a bit of space here for Kelly. Inside forward 50. Allen was the target. Goes beyond him, over the boundary line and out of bounds. We've just been told that number 56 is Matt Tempone. So I should have trusted you in the first place. Yeah. Apologies.
Noble Park have taken control
of the
connoisseur of names.
I think you would have learnt by now, just to trust me.
Noble Park have taken control of the midfield here early in the second quarter. Bowen are really struggling to get the ball into their forward line.
Well, it's not as open as it was. The more open this game gets, the more it suits Bowen.
Yep.
And Noble Park have been very good at been getting it on their terms.
Fake tries to get it around. Snapshot on goal. Great work there for the big ruckman. Forget what I said in the first end, because Bergen Fake has just kicked an absolute beauty from 35, and four straight now unanswered goals to Noble Park. They move on to 5-5-35. Bowen left in arrears 2-6-18. We've got 8 minutes second term here on Pancake Parlour AFL Game Day.
It's been very good today, Fake, at getting first hands out of the stoppage himself, despite being in the ruck contest. He's got four or five clearances of his own. He's followed up his own tap work magnificently, and what a finish. What a finish that was from 40.
Correct.
5-5-35, plays 2-6-18. Happy talking to myself. I'm certainly used to doing that. Handball that wide to McDonald. That's chopped off. Coming in is Mitchum. Handball's out to Robinson. It's Trent Robertson for Noble Park. just in a bit of the hastiness, just kicks it up to half forward. No real method to that. Kennedy is tackled by Dorr. We'll have a ball up.
I think where Fake is really having it over Meeson at the moment is he's around the ground. He seems a lot more mobile.
Yeah, I've seen Johnny Meeson here, especially at this ground, dominate games of footy around the ground and just be fantastic. He's been quiet today. I haven't called his name too much.
Three wins from three so far in Junior Interleague. Our girls got up earlier this morning for their first win ever in Junior Interleague. 15-13-103 over Yarrow Junior, 117. The boys in the under 15-2s, that's Aaron Bailey's side, 20-13-135, defeated the Western Region 4-6-30. And the under 14Bs have got up 6-14-50, defeating the Western Region 2-4-16.
Gee, I reckon we might get a clean sweep today against that lot, mate.
Yeah. Some great work by our young Eastern Football League stars.
Yep.
Free kick going the way of Fake on centre wing. Looked to handball to Martin, but decided against it. There's a bit of movement up forward, which is what you want to see.
Bang.
It's Wright and Allen there for the Bulls. Penderbury's up there for the Tigers and got Leibson's there for Baldwin as well. He thumps it through.
A fair old roost.
Absolutely, it is. It is a rush behind. So 5-6-36, Noble Park. Baldwin 2-6-18. Three straight kicks, 18 points of margin. 10.5 minutes gone here in the second term.
Got Leibson, gets back to Weatherald, and now they move it to a centre wing. Hughes was almost tunnelled, trying to get it away there, and held up right on the boundary line. There was Gordon.
I reckon what Noble Park are doing is they are playing SEN Park exactly the way that you should be playing it. Long and straight down the middle and putting the back line of Baldwin's right under pressure.
So ball thrown in, centre wing out of side. Plenty of numbers around for the Bulls. Now it's held up once again. So trying to work it out. This time Martin finds a bit of space, gets it inside forward 50. Allen the target, bouncing ball, does it well, manages to just tap it onto Cody. Cody on the left boot, sends one in from 35.
The Bulls are on fire!
And they are unstoppable at the moment, Noble Park. And he becomes the fifth goal kicker on the board. 6-6-42 Noble Park, 2-6-18 Baldwin. We've gone 11 minutes, and it's been 11 minutes of hell for Baldwin because it's all been Noble Park in this second term. Grant Subi-Campbell, thanks to Tuesday.
Inside 57-3, this quarter in favour of Noble Park. Clearances are 6 apiece, but Noble Park have won the last 5, and they're winning the contested ball 19-12.
Yeah, that's where I reckon there's been a big difference in that quarter. That stat there, contested ball, Subi.
They haven't even looked like scoring in this second term, the Tigers. Much to the chagrin of the home fans out here, have gone a little quiet. Martin, handball's out wide, kicks from Monaghan is smothered. He goes back in and wins his own footy. Tyson Mitchum's just been bullocking his way through everything so far this afternoon, and he's on the bottom of that pack there.
This is where the Bulls are at their best, getting down and dirty.
Absolutely right. So Haynes has now moved into the ruck for Noble Park. Kyle Martin, handball's out wide. That's Bain for the Tigers, who chops it off. Gilchrist now puts the afterburners on. Handball's back to Bain. He's got a few tackles to get around. One of Tim Kelly is the one that eventually bundles him out over the boundary line. So on the far side here, Bang smacks centre of the ground here at SEN Park. Tempone takes it out of the ruck. Should have been penalised. Umpire says play on, though. Now the Tigers should be able to take advantage of this going inside 50. Got Leibson to Hughes. A kick from Got Leibson's a shocker. The ball comes to ground level. Trent Robinson just has to pick the footy up and the Bulls are away. Mitchum, Tobin, through his legs. Got Leibson again. He's wrapped up in the tackle. The rain starts falling again. Which is when you've got a 4-goal lead. Very, very handy.
Look at them all roll into the bowls club.
There's Haynes. Tapped down to Anderson. Kick goes straight up and straight down. Got Leibson tries to take the mark. It wouldn't have been paid regardless. Keane leads into the race for this one. Allen gets a hand in. Handball from McDonald, the birthday boy this afternoon. Martin hacks it off the ground. Who's going to run onto this one first? It's all Baldwin. Weatherald. Back to Milhausen. Milhausen over the top. Great mark going back at the flight of the ball by Tregear, who spins out of a bit of trouble as well. That looked lovely. Handball through back to Gilchrist, who does some spinning of his own. Back to Tregear. Inside 50 now, low ball. Danny Hughes, good mark on the lead out in front. Handball's to Tregear. This would be a great play from Shane Tregear. Oh, Gordon and Goebbels, no chat. They both spent it before they had it. Either of them could have taken that mark. They've just cost themselves a shot on goal there, the Tigers, just through lack of talk. We'll have a ball up right at the top of the square. Tempone and Haynes up in the ruck for the other side. Tempone's going to get a free kick.
Just he copped
an errant juke to the nose. A little bit unlucky. Certainly accidental, but a free kick nonetheless. And Tempone, from as good as directly in front, 5 metres out, is going to go back to try and put the third goal on the board and stop a run of five consecutive goals from Noble Park.
Yeah, can't afford to be giving the Tigers easy goals here.
Has to go through, and the left foot kicks a shocker. He misses it, and it cops a little rubber. The head two on the way past. That's inexcusable from there. 2-7 Bourne now, 19. Noble Park, 6-6-42. And I thought early they might have been kicking themselves out of it. Now they can't even kick them to get themselves back in it.
Gee, even I've missed them there from kick to kick, Paul.
Yeah, well, you're not playing Division 1 either, will you, Brash?
And it's not only the missed goal, it's the momentum shift
that
would absolutely
have
come with it.
If they go down the other end now and put one through, that's a backbreaker.
It's a fair old ruse. That's gone right to the middle of the ground for there from Morrison. Noble Park will regain possession here through Tobin. Kick out wide. The only man out there, Trakeer. He'll lead in the chase. I think the boundary line might beat all comers. And eventually it rolls over in front of McDonald's.
One of the recent criticisms about Noble Park is they've been not being able to get near the ball, you know, contested and in the stoppages. Going back to a man-on-man situation, they're starting to back themselves and they're starting to find that form again.
So Tempone wins a tap down, cross in front position, tried to get it away, eventually got his handball over to Gordon. Now they find a bit of space, Trakeer gets it away to Weatherald, working in a phone box, and now they find a bit of space. Roach kicks up towards half forward. It's a 2-on-1, two almost wins out. Umpire said that one did win out.
Hughes
been held.
Hughes at centre half forward. Short chip kick over the top to Cross was dangerous, but he's going to play on and kicked into an empty goal square. The skipper's there as well, but in the end it's a goal the way of Sean Cross, and that's the one that they desperately needed, the Bourne Football Club. And it's their third on the board, 3-7-25, Noble Park 6-6-42. 16 minutes gone, second term here on AFL Game Day.
Just about to mention, they had to find a way to get Cross back into the game, because for the 16 minutes in this second term, he hadn't done much. He did some good work on the halfback flank a moment ago. Before that, it took a great mark from the kick from Hughes, and the finish was just as good. So he's a super player, Sean Cross, and when the ball is in his hands more often than not, Bourne are going to be competitive. So good from him, and hopefully that kickstarts the rest of this second term, who the Bourne Footy Club really need to fight back. And Roach,
what's going on?
It's got to burst away from this stoppage. And umpire's going to, it's paid a free kick to Bourne. So it begs the question, when is an advantage?
The advantage of the free 20 metres in front of him wasn't enough.
Exactly. So Weatherwood takes a free kick and swings around on the left, inside 50. There's Matty Lee at the top of the ball. Smart kick. Gordon's in this as well. Gobel's in this rather.
Goals.
He's got plenty of time, plenty of space, and plenty of talent. Jeffy Gobel's from the boundary. There's your Coropedic betting goal of the day so far. That's a river from Jeffy Gobel's. His second. They got two quick ones. Marches back to 11. Can you believe it?
It just shows you, right, that if you make a simple mistake, very simple basic mistakes, Baldwin can make you pay. Two goals in a minute, and they're back right into the contest here.
It's one of those games that no side wants to win it.
That's right. No.
Gain some ascendancy and then all of a sudden let the other side back in. As Cross tries to get his kick away, Martin ends up giving a handball out to Fake, who just roosts one inside 40, looking for a marking option, finds it, Dorr. Man on the mark about 45 from home.
Should be 25, he's taking that mark right, I reckon, right where the paint of 40 was.
So, man on the mark's pretty, he'll have to kick from 55. Looks pretty confident with it as well. Comes in now to stem the flow of two straight goals. The Baldwin likes it off the boot, might not have the distance, and in the end it's touched right on the line. And it threw for one behind. So 6-7-43 Noble Park. Baldwin 4-7-31. Two straight kicks in it. The Bulls lead this one on AFL Game Day.
Criddle Prendergrift from fullback. Of course, the older brother of Collingwood Premiership superstar Scott. Norm Smith medalist, three-time Anzac Day medalist, not a bad footballer, Scott. Chris just as good too. There's a long kick from him out to the centre wing position. He was looking for Fraser. Just hits his hands and goes out of bounds for a boundary showing. Right out in front of our Coropedic betting boundary riders, which is where we'll go right now.
There's a couple of quick goals from Cross and Galvez. It's just given really a lot of enthusiasm for the Baldwin team, and the local crowd is just finding a lot of voice now.
There's almost a five-goal margin before, and all of a sudden it's just back to two kicks. The handball from Meeson. Meeson was looking for Roach, but it's stolen by Anderson. He's right outside of the right foot kick. Bounces up towards half forward. Trakeer goes back in and lends some support for the Tigers. Kick up to Gobel's on centre wing in front of Robertson. Takes the mark. Handball's to Weatherald. It goes to Hughes. Strong grab. And umpire might pay 25 here. Geordie Buckingham, he doesn't. Handball's back to Gobel's. Short to Gilchrist. Right out in the middle of the ground. He's got Bain out wide and Kennedy as well. They can raffle it. Kennedy takes the mark. Keane does some sharp work on the mark there. Short ball. Kick over the top to Bain. Strong mark on the lead. Kemperman makes him earn every bit of it. Strong grab.
That's ball in football.
Kemperman wearing him like a glove.
I think he's rolled straight over his ankle too. He's a bit ginger.
Absolutely earned that mark. Hard up against the boundary line he is. It's going to take a good kick. Not the hardest spot on this ground here at SEN Park. Just hangs it out to the left-hand side. Drifting in and almost taking a great mark was Gilchrist. It's a great tackling on the line. We'll have a ball about a metre out from goal.
He is extremely lucky not to be having a free kick against him here. Tried to take
trying
him
to
all
score the try.
Yeah.
Door, that's pretty dumb footy from Brett Door. That's a free kick.
Deliberate.
That's gone through on the full from the ruck contest. And it has to be a free kick to the Bournemouth Footy Club. Absolutely. Absolutely.
Learn the rules, Dory!
Free kick every day of the week. Bit of advice from up here on the balcony too. I don't mind hearing that. And Danny Hughes, the former South Cordon Bulldog.
Smart footy, Dory!
Take the free kick a metre out from goal. Oh, Hughes has given it up. Jeffy Gables is going to take it. Oh, no. Made an absolute mess of it. Absolute mess of it. And it'll be a free kick to the Bulls in the opposite forward pocket.
The Tigers supporters went quiet pretty quick.
And the free kick's going to go the way of Ben Joby.
Benny Joby right at fullback. In enemy territory at the moment. And kicks up towards centre wing commentary side. Massive pack fly, no one could take the mark. Fake, eventually got his kick away. Managed to find Martin. Tackled as he kicked it by Fraser. Anderson also in there as well. It's a hot football and Roach sees it over the boundary line and out of bounds. Just says, how do you do to Craig Anderson? Pretty sure Ando's got the points in that battle.
So far, yes.
In terms of career.
Yes.
Particularly in the Eastern Footy League, a legend of AFL footy as Tobin takes it away. Kick up towards half forward. Allen just couldn't pick it up. So I think it might be Harper. And eventually gives it away. Got Leapson. He was tackled, wrapped up very quickly by Anderson. Now they can try and get it away. Harper eventually gets it inside forward 50. Wright just shuffled Pendlebury out of the battle, but couldn't make the most of it. And Weatherwood will take it away off half back for Baldwin.
Does not waste the footy this boy, Jacko Weatherwood. No exception there. Short ball to Tregear, who's owned that far wing in the last 10 minutes. And Fake, drifting across, takes a strong mark at centre half back. Ambles to Kemperman, who sent it back to where it was before. But there's plenty of balls and there's plenty of space. It's Keane and Monaghan. They're going to rappel it together. It sits up for Keane, who kicks it in the direction of Wright over the top of his head. Then he back towards the goal square. Off the ground!
Oh,
Cody it was. Just on the wrong side of the stick. And behind there. Good footy from the Bulls. They moved it quick. And good work there from Mitch Gent and Keane as well at half forward. Roach in the middle of the ground. Waste no time. Fast moving of the footy. Finds Johnny Meeson, the former Melbourne big man, who takes the mark. Handballs, I think it's a Fraser it was, who's got cross. Tregear, who's on fire at the moment. Tregear looks to go to Weatherwood, who was on his wrong side, so he doesn't handball it there. The left foot kick from Tregear in the direction of Gobles. Gets rid of Robinson. He's got time. He's got space. He's got his third goal. Oh, Jeffy Gobles. He's turned the game on its head from that forward pocket in this term. Another great goal from the same spot. His third. The margin back to just 7 points here. Noble Park 6-8-44, Bourne 5-7-37. The stand-in skipper has three, and he's got another contender for the Carapetic Pinning goal of the day.
And that's why he was the EFL captain, because it's moments of inspiration that get your side back into a contest, and he's done that in this quarter so far, Dyson.
That was exactly what Brett Moyle said when he awarded him the captaincy. He said he kicks big goals in big games, and that's exactly what he's done with two in this second term, one in the first so far. But Noble Park try and go forward once again. Harper was tackled, eventually got it away to Dore. Held without it, there was Anderson. Now Bourne regain possession, although not very well. Got Leapson, eventually gets it away to Cross. Now they go out to half back, but Fake is all there by himself. There's a shepherding, an think it was against Giobi. So Weatherill gets the free kick, finds Roach, handballs over the top to Gilchrist, who can run to 40 and send this one home. Decides to go short, looking for Goebbels. Probably could have gone home.
I reckon that was really poor judgment there by Taylor Grove Gilchrist. He had an open goal. He should have just gone straight for it.
To Goebbels conscious there. What you can fall into that trap when a guy is hot.
24 minutes, second term. Deep in the pocket here for Baldwin.
Just went to him that one time too many.
So, trying to get around one here. Fraser O'Regan tried to throw it on the boot. Now gaining possession there was Kelly. And kicks out wide, finds a bit of touch. That one's going to go very deep. And eventually it's over the boundary line by Roach. About 50 metres out from the Baldwin goal.
I know Baldwin have got back into the contest, but I reckon that I think Dan Donati still will not be happy, and I think we'll be hearing his vocal tones at halftime.
On 25 minutes here in the second term, we've seen some Noble Park dominance, and Baldwin have fought back nicely. Handball out there from Ghent. He was looking for Robertson. O'Regan comes in and picks it up, and Robertson deals with him.
It's that genuine half of two quarters.
It is.
You know that.
It is.
Quarter of two halves,
however you want to put it.
Fake and Meeson again.
Shut your mouth.
Gets the tap down to Joby, who gives away the free kick for a high fend off. It's there every day of the week. It's a bit stiff, but it's there. To the other way of Cross. They've got plenty of numbers back here, the Bulls, so it's going to have to be smart here, Cross.
Already got, 25 gone.
It's got Gordon in a one-on-one, and there's a block you want to kick it to in a one-on-one. Gordon, Trigueira down there, Gordon! Oh, is it from Q? He read the script. He could see that happening from a mile away. Takes the mark over Corrigan. And this to cut the margin back to a point.
We've talked about a bloke like Ben Giobi being, taking the EFL by storm. But this guy really is, he's come to play since he started in the EFL. Tell you what, he's a nice build, takes a nice mark, moves like a sleek Jaguar, this boy.
So here he goes here. 15 metres out. Barely an angle to speak of. We saw Tempone miss one from the same spot. Gordon won't make the same mistake. That's gone straight through the middle. He's got two. The margin back to a point. 6-8-44, plays 6-7-43. A cracking game of footy for Queen's Birthday weekend.
Yeah, these are the contests that we love, Paul. Close, with no give and take in this one.
26 and a half minutes gone, second term. Not too much longer to half time, I would suspect.
No.
We wait for the ball to be returned.
Boundary.
Cross boundary side, thanks to chiropractic betting, Esmond Aponzo.
Even though the Noble Park run and fake is doing really well, but just the ball, the sharking and just the movement of the ball from Baldwin is fantastic and giving them opportunities now.
Certainly is. Ball's back in the middle once again, and now Noble Park will try and clear away through the legs there of Monaghan. Couldn't make the most of it. Now it comes out to the centre wing. Fraser was held without an umpire's call. Play on. Bull picked it up and ran with it. Now goes in towards the forward 50. Dorr, hasn't he been super today?
Has been.
Turned it on early in this term.
What's going on here?
I think Jordan Buckingham's going to bring him back on his mark. I think the kick initially wasn't all that flash, so I'd be more than happy for it to come back. 27 and a half minutes gone. So Dorr with it, 60 from his goal at the White Horse Road end of the ground here at SEM Park. Elects to go long, now to the hot spot, 25 metres out directly in front, can't find a fly. Many numbers round at the bottom of the pack, it just smothered, and now Baldwin a chance to get it away. Wright was held by Keane, going nowhere. And we'll have another ball up.
Just start to slow down the last couple of minutes, which is probably fair enough, seeing as the first 20 minutes of that quarter was played at such a frenetic pace. Haynes is on ground level, went on hands and knees. It's when they've been able to get on top when Fake's been out of the ruck and Haynes has gone in. But he'll go up here against Tempone. Get the tap down too. He's looking for Wright. Goes through his hands. Hits Pendlebury in the face. Drops to ground level. Anderson's there on hands and knees. Wright's quick snap out of the pack. Just onto the hands. It goes back to Martin. His left foot kick up towards the goal square. Tries to go through, but eventually does. I'm just waiting for that one to be bundled over a rush behind. But eventually we'll see a ball up next to the behind post.
Throw in.
Same thing. It'll be Haynes. This one will be Wright and Tempone. Wright just gets rid of Tempone. Far too strong, far too big. And the Tigers good enough to relieve a little bit of the pressure, at least for the time being. Milhausen sit underneath that, take a good grab. Uncontested in the end. Knights and a half back, Johnny Milhausen.
Numbers everywhere, he just can't make up his mind.
Exactly, plenty of options, and you think you just play the percentages, and that's exactly what he does. Hughes, good mark over the back there by Morrison Ryan. He should use his left foot, might swing out back across here, find a teammate in the middle of the ground. It's exactly what he does. There's a lot of air on it though, gives everybody a chance to come and have a crack at it. No one able to take the mark. Gordon that time, lands like a cat with the footy in hand. Keane, opportunistic, inside forward 50, right at the back, over the top of Gottliebs and hands to it, couldn't take the mark. He's done that a few times today. Sharon in dispute now, right too big and too strong. Just lets the footy come out. McDonald handballs out wide to Weatherald. And his first mistake by foot. It had to happen at some stage, and it's out of bounds on the full. Out in front of the nets. Wright's got hands to a lot of ball this afternoon. Just hasn't able to clunk the big, been able to clunk the big mark. Beach has the free kick. Be a tough ask from there. Hard up against the boundary line. Wrong side for a right footer. About 40 metres out. Gone 30 minutes here, so can't be too long left. Let's see how that looks off the boot. Oh, he loves every bit of it. That's a great kick. That's a big-time goal right on the half-time siren. 7-8-50 the Bulls. Bowen 6-7-43. Mr. Show, uncontested shots on goal. Well, you make of them what you will. And Beach made the absolute most out of that. His first 7 points, 30 and a half minutes gone here in the second quarter.
Just a little important momentum shift just back to Noble Park. Just on the stroke of half time.
About a minute to go.
Benefits of being right next to the timekeepers.
Yep.
We'll keep you updated all through the afternoon because this one there looks like it's going to go right down to the wire. Tim Pone tries to get it around. He swung around three times. Umpire let him go. Tobin takes a mark for Noble Park at half back. Kicks wide. Finds his target there in Monaghan, who goes further afield looking for Keane. Marked unopposed, about 50 from home. Hard up against the boundary line. Moving on. Can't be too much longer left. Looks like he's going to back himself in. Top of the square. Now he eventually goes for the short chip kick and finds it. And plucking it out of the air there was Kyle Martin. A great mark contested, and this would be handy. This will make it 13 points right on the stroke of half-time, Brash.
You would expect Kyle Martin, a player of his class, to slot this right through the middle on the eve of half-time.
Already has one for the quarter. Just to make it two and make it a two-goal lead for the Bulls. Comes in now and stays it right, but manages to sneak it through. And his second on the board, and a 13-point lead to the Noble Park Football Club. 8-8-56 Noble Park, Bowen 6-7-43. Just when you think one side's gaining a bit of momentum, the other side just plucks them back.
With a minute and a half to go in this quarter, the margin was a point.
Yep.
And all of a sudden it's out to 13. that's a real back-breaking work in terms of what Dan Donati would be thinking. To give away two goals in absolute red time in the second half.
Doesn't get any red. It was almost.
But unusually, we've gone, 32 minutes too. So, I mean, it's been a long quarter.
Yeah, but these are the important parts of games. That's a great tackle from Cole Martin back in the middle of the ground. The sun's shining here at SEN Park too. We've seen some rain. Now we're seeing some sun. Sorry, not too far away. 13-point lead after that. They opened up. There it is. That's the end of the second quarter. That was a bloody good quarter of footy, that Brash.
10 goals.
The Bulls opened up a four-goal lead at one stage. The Tigers cut it back to a point, and now it's 13 points at the main interval. We're in for a cracking second half of footy.
Well, we are, and the fact is that once again, Noble Park, look, they just love coming down to SEN Park. You know, this game to them means a hell of a lot, and they've come to play in the first half. The question is, can they go on with it in the second half?
Multiple goal scorers for Bowman. Goebbels has three and Nathan Gordon has a couple. And for the Bulls, two to Wright and two to Martin. We'll have a short ad break here. When we come back, we'll have the halftime show. Plenty to talk about there. So make sure you stay right here on 98.1 FM Radio Eastern, the home of the Eastern Football League.